Today, we're excited to talk about the concept of correlation in the unified SecOps experience in Microsoft Defender and why it is so important. Correlation helps make sense of large amounts of data by identifying relationships and patterns. The correlation engine built into the unified platform collects alerts from various security tools and systems and then analyzes them to find connections and patterns. When detection mechanisms in your environment generate an alert, we decide whether to place that alert in a new incident or an existing one. Generally, if an incident is unique across all sources within a specific time frame, Defender creates a new incident. If the alert is related to other alerts, even from different sources within the same time frame, it is added to an existing incident. To help you understand how we've correlated those alerts to an incident, you can go into the alerts linked to the incident. You'll see that they can be linked based on entities present in the alerts, such as assets, users, devices, mailboxes, and others. Or they might be linked because of artifacts. As in this example, alerting on similar files, or processes, or email senders. Correlation activities continue even after incidents have been created, but only during realistic timeframes. We wouldn't correlate an incident from a year ago with something happening right now. The engine searches for and detects commonalities and relationships between incidents and alerts constantly. When incidents or alerts are sufficiently alike, we merge them into a single incident. We use top-notch advanced correlation mechanisms, but you might disagree whether a given alert belongs with a particular incident. In such a case, you can unlink an alert from one incident and link it to another. Let's look at these two incidents as an example. Each has the same affected assets, and after some behind-the-scenes investigation, we concluded that they were actually part of the same instance. We can now link the alerts to the other incident. You can do this within the alert, or by selecting Move Alert. Keep in mind that every alert must belong to an incident. You can either link the alerts to another existing incident, that's what we're doing now, or you can create a new incident on the spot. Also, please be sure to provide feedback on these manual correlations when asked, because with your permission, we want to research the reason why you want to have it correlated and improve our engine. Now, a valid question would be, why wasn't this alert correlated by the engine? Well, under certain circumstances, the correlation engine won't merge incidents. For example, it won't merge if one of the incidents has a status of closed. We will not reopen incidents for merging reasons, and we won't merge the source and target incidents if they are assigned to two different people, which is actually what happened in this case. As you can see, the incident and the alert were assigned to Ragnar and Naomi, so they could not have been merged. If you have one assigned incident, for example, one assigned to me and the other not assigned yet, the incidents can be merged. If the source and target incidents have two different classifications, however, they can't be merged. As you can see here, one incident has a benign positive, and another is a true positive. Those incidents would not be merged because they have different classifications. We also have a condition that blocks two incidents from being merged. When doing so would raise the number of entities to the maximum allowed. The last condition is when two incidents contain devices in different device groups. Those are reasons why we would not merge. Now, when two or more incidents are merged, the contents of one incident, the source incident, are migrated into the other incident, the target incident. And the source incident is then automatically closed, and you can no longer see it. It's no longer available in the portal, and any reference to that source incident is redirected to the target incident, so that one is handled. Now, what happens with all the information when we merge two incidents? For this, I want to show you two uncorrelated incidents. Someone visited a suspicious domain with a couple of tags. We also have some comments in the activity log. And, as you can see, this incident has no entity, so we could not have merged with anything similar, because there's nothing to merge with. The other instance is a connection to an unpopular website that was detected. We have some tags and comments in the activity log. We also have research now, and we think those two incidents should have been merged. We can merge them in the portal. Click the two incidents and merge them. We can also add a comment explaining why we merged them. Then look at how the information is merged. An alternative technique is to merge incidents by linking all the alerts from one incident to the other. Now, if we investigate the correlated incident, we can see that all the alerts are correlated and merged. We have the entities from one of the incidents because the other one didn't have any entities. All the alerts are mentioned. We have all the tags that are merged. If you go into the activity log, you see that the comments are merged as well. We have the two original comments from each incident and then an additional comment for the merging. The correlation engine transforms isolated alerts into actionable insights, enabling you to have a more proactive and efficient approach to cybersecurity. If you want to know more, check out our docs and the tech community.